The Huion HS64 is a mini drawing tablet that works with computers like you would expect, but it also works on Android phones and tablets. Android devices only, this doesn't work on iPhones or iPads. The HS64 is compatible with every program I tested except for Moho animation software, so I expect it'll work in most standard or free drawing programs. I'm going to go through the box, explain how to set up the HS64 and troubleshooting, and do a review. What's in the box? The tablet with 6.5 by 4 inches of active drawing area, 4 shortcut buttons and non-slip pads on the back, wireless pen with 2 shortcut buttons, 2 packs of extra pen tips and a tip remover, 5-foot long tablet cable, adapters for the cable, manual. To use the tablet on your Android device, first make sure you're running Android 6.0 or higher. It won't work below that. Your device's settings, system settings, or about page will show what version you have. Next, plug the cord into the tablet, pick the adapter end that fits your device, plug that to the other end of the cable, and then plug the cable into your Android device. In this case, the tablet worked without having to do anything else, just plug it in and play. On some devices, you will need to go into Settings and enable OTG for the tablet to work. When you plug the tablet into an Android device, the tablet switches to phone mode, where you can only draw on the left side. If your tablet does not switch automatically, press and hold the top left button for 3 seconds to turn on phone mode. Some other important things to know: you cannot use the tablet's shortcut buttons or the pen's shortcut buttons when plugged into an Android device. Those only work on computers. Also, you can't rotate your Android device to draw in landscape mode. It only works in the regular up and down position. Pressure sensitivity does work. And now on to computer setup. For computers, you do need to install a driver. So first, uninstall any other tablet drivers. If you uninstall something, restart your computer. Go to huion.com/download. Type in HS64. Download the driver for Windows or Mac, depending on what you use. Right-click, extract. Double-click, install. Plug your tablet into your computer. Tablet settings show up in 2 places, on the desktop and in the icon tray. Open the settings and click the Administrator Privileges button first. Click Yes, OK to the pop-up, and wait a couple seconds for the panel to activate. Okay, now you can change settings. Set your shortcut buttons at the top. In the second tab, set the pen's shortcut buttons. Use the right-hand slider to change how sensitive the pen pressure is. On the bottom of this window, if you have problems in any programs, try disabling or enabling Windows Ink. Huion tablets will not work the way you expect in internet browsers like Chrome unless you disable Windows Ink. Turning on mouse mode makes it so that your tablet always picks up where you left the cursor, no matter where on the tablet you hover. Game mode turns off pressure sensitivity, but it increases how fast data goes from the tablet to the computer, so game mode is good for playing games like Osu. In the third tab, you can customize what area the tablet uses to represent your screen. And the last tab lets you export and import your settings, which you may do if you have different settings for different programs. You can also reset the defaults here. That's all for setup. So what do I think of the HS64? Well, I'm amazed something so small works so well. Unlike drawing tablets that have screens, with a screenless tablet you can have a size this tiny and still feel comfortable. And for $35, that's a steal. It's just so cheap. I mean, if I had a few more dollars, I would pick something a tad bigger with more shortcut buttons, but this is great, and the fact you can use it with a phone is pretty cool. I tried drawing with my finger on the phone and it was impossible compared to drawing with the tablet. I don't have a stylus for my phone, so I couldn't compare that. And I guess if you were only planning on drawing on a phone and not a computer, a phone stylus would be the right way to go, assuming your phone is compatible with one and it's pressure sensitive. The fact that you can't rotate the phone to draw in landscape mode was a bit of a letdown, but I didn't have any trouble working in the upright phone position. You really do need a phone stand for this, though. I'm really lucky that I didn't drop my phone and it didn't fall off of this slippery book tower that I made. Often, the on-screen keyboard wouldn't come up with a tablet click, and I'd have to press with my finger to get the keyboard to appear. As for the phone battery drain, it'll vary depending on your phone and the drawing app. For me, using the tablet in Flip-A-Clip cost 8% of battery power per hour. The HS64 tablet pen's pressure sensitivity is fantastic, but you'll notice on a phone its ability is limited by the drawing app that you use. On a computer, you will easily see nice controlled strokes, but phone drawing is a lot less fine-tuned than that. On the computer side, I have no criticisms. Everything about drawing felt smooth and natural. The small drawing area meant I didn't have as much control as I would with a bigger tablet, but that's it, really. For somebody who wants to try out digital art without spending $70, the HS64 is a really good choice. For more drawing tablet reviews, look below or go to scribblekibble.com, click episodes, and then the product reviews button. Hope this helps!